In this video, we'll talk about the critical thickness of insulation. First of all, why we'll give this insulation? We will give insulation to reduce the heat transfer, and we will use the material that is inductor. What is inductors? Inductors are the material which are poor conductivity. So we'll see that the rate of heat transfer from the cylinder increases with addition of insulation, for R2 is less than RCR, that is RCR is critical radius. It reaches a maximum when R2 equal to RCR and starts to decrease for RT is greater than RCR. So I will give one example. We have all seen the electrical wires. The thickness of the insulation will be different according to the price. So the thickness they will decide according to this critical thickness of insulation. See here, this is R1 and R2. R1 is constant for all, but R2 is different. See here, R2 is less than RCR. Here R2 equal to RCR. R2 is greater than RCR. Okay, here we have two resistance, that is RTH convection, that is heat transfer between the insulation and the outside medium. This is RTH convection, and RTH conduction is this one, insulation, that is the pipe insulation or whatever the insulation material. For that, this is the conduction resistance. So we have conduction resistance is 1 by 2 pi K of pipe or insulation into L ln of R2 by R1. Okay, first what will happen means, if the thickness we are increasing, so what will happen means A0 will increase. If A0 is increased, the RTH convection, that is, it will decrease. As A0 is increasing, it will decrease. But in RTH conduction, ln of R2 by R1. So if R2 is increased, the conduction resistance is increased. So we have seen practically that up to some critical resistance, RTH convection will decrease, and after that the conduction resistance will increase. So this is the plot between RTH and critical radius. This is the convective resistance. This is 1 by H0 A0. As R is increasing, the thermal resistance of convective is decreasing, but at the same time the conduction resistance, that is RTH, is increasing. Up to some radius they both will meet, that is critical radius. Before the critical radius, the heat transfer will increase. Why? Because see here, the resistance is very less and decreasing. Up to critical radius, the resistance is decreasing. As resistance is decreasing, the heat transfer will increase. So we are keeping insulation material so that the heat transfer should be not there, but here resistance is decreasing means heat transfer will be there. So up to critical radius, the heat transfer will increase, and after this critical radius, see, the conduction resistance of insulation will come into picture and it will increase the thermal resistance. So after this critical radius only, heat transfer will decrease. So whenever we are designing the insulation, we should see that the thickness should be greater than RCR. See, this is the Q versus radius. See, before critical radius, this is called leading zone, because the Q is increasing. At critical radius it will be maximum, and after this it will be decreased. For insulation, we want the heat transfer should be decreased, so our radius should be always greater than this critical radius, so that insulation may come and the heat transfer will be less. So in next video we will see how to calculate the critical thickness, and we'll see one problem also. Thanks for watching this video.